What is up, guys? 806 Anglers here, and welcome back to another video. Today's video, we're going to be fishing at this lake behind us, and we're going to try to attempt to catch largemouth bass, white bass, crappie, and hopefully a walleye and a catfish. I don't know if we'll catch a walleye here. We might have to go way out there, but I don't have the John boat today. But today we're going to be fishing on land, and we're going to see if we can catch some fish today. And this is one of my most favorite lakes to ever fish around my area, and hopefully you will see why today. So let's go ahead and get into it and hopefully catch us some freaking fish. I caught two crappie on this thing, and I missed a white bass. Oh wait, yeah, I caught one crappie on this thing, and then I missed a white bass on it, and then I caught one on a power swimmer or something like that. They're stacked up on these rocks. I'm even hoping for some walleye, but so hopefully we can get a walleye on hand. That would be nice, but I don't think we will. Now my sister's using a bait caster now. This is her first time out fishing with it. She's been practicing in the backyard, but I brought one of my trout spoons. I use these for trout. I used them this summer, and I freaking absolutely slayed them on some of these. It wasn't this exact one, but some like these in a different color. If you haven't seen that video, I'll drop it down below. But I was out in Utah using one of those spoons. Oh crap. And I was absolutely slaying them, and I brought this one, and I feel like the white bass would go crazy for it. So that's what we're doing. No. Got one. Oh, I just had a hit, guys. On the dang spoon. I knew this would have been the ticket. That was definitely a white bass for sure. That was a good one. Oh, dang. My fish just jumped right there. I don't know what it was. I'm going to throw it over here and see if I can figure out what just jumped. Something jumped right here. Right in front of my catfish rod. Oh! A white bass just followed it up here. A white bass just freaking followed it up here. Oh! Got one. Oh, it's a crappie. Got a crappie. Yep. Got a crappie on the spoon, but I definitely was being followed by a white bass. This guy's gonna be too short to keep. Hopefully we can get on some keeper size crappie or white bass. But yeah, that's a white crappie. My sister just got stuck on the rocks. But yeah, caught a crappie, missed another white bass. I know for a fact it was one. And then one followed it. Come on. Well, there goes my spoon. Lost my spoon. I didn't bring any more spoons either. Oh, but I got this though. I don't think the marina had any spoons either, sadly. All right, show us your catch. Jocelyn just caught a crappie on the, was it the power swimmer? I'll have to show you guys what it is. It's just a little white swim bait. One of those things on her first fish on the bait cast combo. All right, guys, got my first keeper crappie. He's just barely over 10 inches, and our limit is 10 inches and above. This one made it. It's past 10. We're going to keep this guy. All right, guys, got another white crappie, and he's hooked really, really well. Once again, on this little lure I found at McDonald Lake with Jake, and this thing's putting in the freaking work. You know, I came out here wanting to catch some white bass, but I do not mind catching these guys at all. Crappie tastes really, really good, but it would definitely be a bonus to catch one white bass, but I'm not minding it at all catching these crappie. I love catching them, and I love eating them. All right, guys, this guy's almost 11, and he's going on the stringer with the other one. We got two keeping size crappie. Crappie are delicious, and he's gonna give out some good freaking fillets. Let's continue. Alright, guys, got another one. This one's 9 inches. I'm gonna throw this one back. And I caught him on this. Caught him on this thing's basically like a little fluke with a green jig head. So hopefully we catch some white bass and some more good sized crappie. I got some other stuff that we can use as well. And so here in a minute, I'm probably gonna set up my camera up behind me. My GoPro unfortunately died. It's charging in the truck right now. So here in a little bit, I'll get it back and we'll be rocking and rolling. But yeah, that bait that I was just killing them on, I lost it and I got it stuck on the rocks. And so yeah, I switched to this thing and I think we're gonna do good with this thing. If not, we got some other stuff as well. We got a handful of stuff to try and we're gonna be catching some more slabs. All right guys, so we're gonna continue crappie fishing. We're fishing around these rocks. This is a drop off. We're gonna keep chucking it along and seeing if we can catch some more crappie and hopefully even a white bass. So we'll see and let's go get started. Just throwing this guy out. Just kind of popping it, keep reeling it. Give it a pause every once in a while, then pop it again and start reeling it. Got one. Got one, guys. Woo! Look at that. Got one. I don't know if it'll keep, but look at that. Boom. On that middle, just like I told you guys. On that, this is a bass assassin, I believe. 10 on the dot, so we're going to go and put them on the stringer. Once again, I was catching them on this. And it's pretty dang hot today. It's like almost in the 90s. And we're just straight slaying them today. Everything's out here. There's a lot of action. A lot of fish are jumping. Like I said, I lost two white bass. Got another one. Look at that. Look at that black crappie. The others are definitely white crappie. This one might keep. Look at that. He completely swallowed that. That's crazy. Oh, I think I got him in the eye. Well, that's unfortunate. Got it out on that minnow, like I was saying. Look how beautiful that crappie is, though. Man, beautiful dark, dark colors. That's what you call a black crappie right there. He's a 10 incher. He's gone on the stringer. And here in Texas, I believe the crappie limit is actually 25. I don't think I'm going to keep 25 of them. I already got four now. I believe this is my fourth one. But we'll see how much I'm going to keep. I don't know really how much I'm going to keep. I think 25 is just too much. But we're going to put this guy on the stringer. Got a nice black crappie on the Bass Assassin minnow. It's just straight killing it, guys. It's fun out here. Got another one, guys. Another black crappie. That one's definitely gonna keep. Man, I'm having a blast on this thing. This slab I just caught trying to catch a freaking white bass. Caught on one of those spoons. It's an untapped fishing spoon. It's this pink one down here. Caught him on that one. Absolute freaking slab, dude. That's like 12 inches probably. Holy crap, that's freaking awesome. I'm gonna measure him. I already know he's a keeper, but I want to see exactly how long he is. I'm guessing 12. Let's go ahead and measure him though. All right guys, so we're back at it again. I've been catching fish left and right. I'll show you the cooler here in a minute. So basically what went on while the camera was off, I have caught a really good sized black crappie. I did catch a white bass finally, and it was about 11, 12 inches. I'll show you guys in a minute. And then my phone actually overheated, so, and the truck wasn't here because, oh, she's got one. Oh, she's using a spinning rod now because I wanted to make a long cast and catch a fish. Because with her bait caster, she's not exactly adjusted to it yet. And she can't really cast very far. So I'm letting her use that. I'm using my bait caster. I have caught some on the bait caster. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Put you on the chesty and catch some more fish. And then later we're going to go swimming. Because like I said, I'm not going to keep 25 crappie. I have about 9 and the limit's 25 here. But let me go ahead and show you the cooler. And there is the white bass right there. Nice little white bass. And then there's one of the black crappies. My sister just caught a white crappie.
Oh.
And go ahead and unhook it and release it.
Don't know how to do that, buddy.
Okay, well, I'll unhook it. There's her little white crappie. She got one. Go wipe, clean them off and then throw them back. All right, you're good. Just, yep, there you go. All right, so let's keep catching some fish. Show them what you're using. Oh, crap, hold on. Oh, oh. All right, so that's what she's using. It's like a storm minnow thing. It's got the treble hook and then the hook on top. And then if you're catching a lot of grass or snagging up a lot, you can always take this off. This has a little split ring right there. But these things are absolutely killer. I only have one of these left, so I need to get more. But I've always liked these things. And these things are just schooling crappie, and that's what I've been catching them on like crazy. That and the little fluke bass assassin thing. So how much fish I've caught on this thing, and it's like freaking, the freaking head's like coming off. But it's still usable, it still swims. All right, guys, so it's the end of the day, and we're actually about to leave. I ended up with 9 fish, 9 crappie, and 1 white bass. The white bass was pretty freaking awesome. You know, I came here wanting to catch a white bass. I have lost 2. I finally got 1, and I'm glad. Today was a great day, an amazing day, and I am blessed for today's day. We caught some awesome fish and a lot of them. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think of this video. If you're new, please consider hitting the subscribe button and the bell notification. Leave a like on this video, comment something down below, and we'll see you on the next one. Tight lines, guys.